Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to talk about Kotlin and TornadoFX, how to get a workspace up and running. Because today was actually the day where the Kotlin Conf Copenhagen really started. Of course, it started actually yesterday, the 4th of December, but that was with some workshops and so today was the real big the first big day with where we had a keynote and there was a lot of sessions. One of the sessions had something with TornadoFX. How cool it was to develop TornadoFX, which is a framework where we which is built on top of JavaFX. So it's actually a way of creating a UI in Java. In the old days, we had this Swing UI, and that was a little replaced with the JavaFX. And now, if you're using Kotlin, then there's something called TornadoFX. The only problem, it looks really, really cool and it is really, really good. But if you look at the guide how to set it up, then I think there are some holes. It could be better the documentation because JavaFX is not included in the OpenJDK, and it's not included when you go up to do like your JavaJDK 11 and plus. So and I would like to use OpenJDK, and I'd also like to use Gradle. And the documentation actually just mentions these lines right here. If we are using Maven, then there is a little bit more documentation. It says down here, if you're using OpenJDK, how should our Maven or pump.xml file, how should that look like? We need to add some more dependencies. We need to add a plugin. But if you're using Gradle, it does not say exactly what to do. So that's what I'm going to show you right now. I've created a new project right here. I chose a new project, and then I chose Gradle, a new Gradle project, and then I chose then I ticked off Kotlin, the JVM, and I removed the Java check mark right there. And I pressed next finished, and then I ended up with a build.gradle file, which I just have deleted everything from because I would like to go through each step right here. First of all, if we look at the documentation, then we need to add a plugin in the top like this. So actually just add a plugin like this, and we should add, of course, the usual group and version, which we have right here. And then we should add that we want some repositories, and we want to use the Maven Central, which is right here. And then we need to add some dependencies, which should be mentioned right here. And then we need to say which target we want to compile to with Kotlin. And in my case, I want to compile to Java 11. And that's actually it. So let us just see right now what actually happened after I copied all these lines in here. We can actually see that source main Kotlin is now seen as a source folder, which is really, really good. If we follow the documentation, then we should actually create something called, create an app, which extends the TornadoFX app. So let me just create a new Kotlin class right here. And I'll just call this my app like this. Add to Git. Yes, thank you very much. And this class, it is, should actually, we'll just keep it simple. This class should extend, and we use colon to show that it should extend. This is Kotlin, so I'll write app, and this is from the Tornado. It is actually not, it's not indexed that yet, and then I should actually say that I want to give the MyView class as an argument to the app, and then I could, if I want to, then I could create a main, but I don't want to do that. I would just skip the main method in here, and I just run it as an application, because the TornadoFX app is already an application itself. So that is one step, but as you can see right now, let me just refresh this one here, let me just synchronize Gradle. Because TornadoFX is not found yet, so I need to add some stuff in the in my build.gradle file, and let me just go down here to dependencies. That should actually be okay. I would actually have expected IntelliJ actually to find app right now. Okay, here it is. Import TornadoFX app. Then my view, and my view is not created yet, so I need to create that. I'll just write new Kotlin class, and then I'll write my view like this. My view will extend a will extend view, which is from Tornado also. So here we have the class my view extends view with no arguments, and here's the class itself, and we need to override something called the root, which is which we want to set to a VBox, which I will not go into details about the components today, but I would just want to show how to get up and running if you're using Gradle and if you're using OpenJDK. And then we can actually add stuff in here. We can add a button if that's what we want to add, and then we can say okay, click here, I'm a button. And we can also add a label if that's what we want to. Look, I'm a label. And of course, we can add as many components as we want to inside this right here. So let me just import the view from Tornado view like this. And already now I get an error. It says cannot access JavaFX scene node. And that's because the JavaFX is not a part of OpenJDK. So that is the first error that we need to tend to. Let me go to my build.gradle file, and then I'll add some stuff right there. Because what we need to add actually is the JavaFX plugin up in the top right here. Then we need to add the JavaFX modules right here. Here we're actually adding the graphics and the media and the controls module and control modules in from JavaFX. And then down under dependencies right here, we need to add all the JavaFX dependencies right there. So, and that also means that we do not need to download anything manually. We can just use this Gradle file. We do not need to go and download JavaFX by itself. We just add it to the dependencies right here. Let me just synchronize. And then I go back to my view. And right now there's no errors. And instead of actually view, then I'll import star instead. Because then I also get the VBox, I get the button label. Those methods here, which actually returns components. See, that's a function actually that returns a button. So I'm actually really happy now, except that if I go to my app now, and if I want to run this, I'll just go edit configuration, and then I'll create. Then the documentation says that I can actually just. I'll just delete this. I'll just press plus right here. Then I should be able to press application. Then I should be able to choose a main class, and in my main class I should just choose my app because this is already an application, so it should be able to run this by default. And then of course I need to set the class path to be the same as the main module. And here right now is JDKE 13, which is fine. Okay. Oh, I set it to unnamed. Let me just give it a good name. My app. Okay. And then it should be possible just to run this class right here. Let's see what happens. There's no compile errors right now, so we fixed a lot of the errors already by changing the build.gradle file. Let's just see what happens now. Look here now what it says here. Error, JavaFX runtime components are missing and are required to run this application. That is because there are something called modules which was introduced at some point. And we have not added a modules file that shows that we actually would like to use the JavaFX. So we are not including the JavaFX modules as we should. We don't need to do that if we don't want to play around with modules, the Java modules, because we are not using that, then we can do something else instead. We can actually create a new Kotlin class with a main inside. my application to run. And then in here, I will then create a companion object. So that means that this is actually my, if you're a Java developer, this is the way to actually start a program with the public void static main, as we're used to in Java. Let me just write main here. I think I can finish it itself. Yes, add JVM static, and then it says function main right here. And then we can actually give it some command line arguments if you want to do that. But instead of doing it, I would actually just like to call my app, and then I'll create a new instance. I don't need to write new because it's Kotlin. And then I'll write my main. This does not exist yet. And then I'll just write array off and then nothing. So that means that now I need to go create my main method right here. So that means that I'm actually overriding the default main. Let me just go back right here. So I'll say function and then main. Then I'll add the args and the array. And it's an array of strings. It's this command line. This is the command line arguments that we are adding right there. And then I want to launch. And then it is help is my app like this. And then the arguments. Oh, arguments there. This is a workaround. So then we don't need to create. Then we don't need to create the modules file if we. Then we'll jump once I add star here because then our launch is also imported. So this is a workaround. If we don't want to use the modules, then we can add this function right, main right here, which actually launches the application. And then we have another application where we have the main method, public static void main, which is actually on the companion object when we're dealing with Kotlin. As soon as we want to create something that is static in Kotlin, then we create a companion object and then we place the function in there. That's just how it works. I've created some Kotlin videos also that you can view if you're not that familiar to Kotlin. It starts with the basics and it also explains the companion object. But let's now try to run this application instead of the my app, then we'll run my application to run and that, and then we just see what actually happens. running. Let's see what happens. Oh, it actually started. Okay, it's actually, sorry, I just didn't see it. It's actually right here, the application is right here. It has click here, I'm a button, and it also has a label. Look, I'm a label, which we set just in the view. This is just the basics. I would like to make more videos about TornadoFX, of course, later on, but this is just to get up and running if you're using Gradle, if you're using OpenJDK, and if you're using, maybe you're using OpenJDK 13, as I am, or maybe 11. This is the way to do it. I'll just start the application again. It's right here. And of course, now it's just up to imagination what kind of views we would like to create. We can also have kind of another label up here. Hello, I'm also a label. It's just up to us. We can also duplicate this one. Another button, and of course we can have event listeners and stuff like that on top of this, but I'll go into this another time. But this was just to get so that now you can actually get your workspace up and running, and then we're ready to code some TornadoFX in Kotlin. Here we have it. Hello, I'm also a label. Click here, I'm a button, another button, and look, I'm also a label. So and so the trick is to create each view and place it in modules, and then some layout managers, etc. But let's talk about that another time. This was just getting up and running with Kotlin TornadoFX OpenJDK 11. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope to see you again very soon, and have a nice evening. Bye-bye.